Hi everybody, in this video we'll start to discuss international harmonization. We will discuss first section of the chapter, reasons for harmonization, obstacles to harmonization, and measurement of harmonization. In this section we will discuss reasons for harmonization, examples of the need for harmonization, obstacles to harmonization, and measurement of organization. Let us go to start this discussion. In your opinion, before we start, what do you think? What's the reasons for harmonization? Let us go to show this example. Some Japanese companies until 2007, they have alternatives to adopt first in, first out, last in, first out, or weighted average to evaluate their ending. And somewhere else, the lower of first in, first out, and net realizable value, common IFRS practice in general, we can say that. The lower of last in, first out, and current replacement cost, common US practice. Suppose we have a company located in the US. For that, they have this alternative to evaluate their inventory, the lower of last in, first out. And the same company as an affiliated company located in Japan. For that, they have another alternative to choose between first in, first out, last in, first out, or weighted. Somewhere else, suppose here, in Palestine, we are obligated to adopt international financial reporting standards when we prepare our financial statement. So we have the alternative to choose between the lower of first in, first out, and net realizable. How can we prepare our consolidated financial statement? We cannot prepare our consolidated financial statement because of the differences between prepared financial statement. Look at the coming example. This is for GlaxoSmith line earnings. When they prepare it under UK GAAP from 1995 until 2004, they have these figures. Compare it with the same in the same years, I mean. Look at the differences between their number when we reconcile it from UK GAAP to the US GAAP. The amount of earnings declined from 717 million to 296 million. We are talking about something around 59% because of only changing the standards or changing the gap that we use to prepare our financial statement. So the differences between countries, because of the differences of laws, differences of culture, differences of tax system, we have discussed many variables that influence the financial statement. These differences had led us to this great amount of difference of earning. So how can we make our decision? This is one of the reasons that we lead us to harmonize our accounting. Also, standardizing or harmonizing the accounting treatment can reduce administrative costs, improve the quality of accounting, and increase comparability. As you know, we discussed this point many times. We have to provide useful information to make decisions. And this information to be useful, it should be relevant to make decisions and faithfully represented the reality of our organization. In addition to enhancing characteristics of accounting information, one of them is comparability. To compare, you have to provide information that can we use to compare it to each other. How can we compare our company that use, for example, first in, first out to evaluate their inventory with someone else who use, for example, last in, first out, or high in, first out, or low in, first out, whatever? How can we compare them? doesn't make sense. We cannot compare them. For that, we aim to minimize the differences between the methods that we use or adopt, aiming to make it comparable. In addition to, we have to provide understandable information. Also, you have to provide verified information, and you have to provide it on time when we need. Because of the differences between the countries, we have a variety of financial statements that we can read. Also, in the same line, reasons for harmonization, investors and financial analysts, how can they read the financial statement? You have to provide them by understandable information, but in this way, you didn't give them understandable information because they cannot read it. Not because of the language, because of the accounting language, because may they couldn't understand your accounting language. As the example that we discussed at the beginning of this video, here we are talking about accounting language, lower of last in first out, lower of first in first out, cost, different alternative in Japan. So this is the meaning of accounting language. How can they understand it to analyze it? How can they understand it to many companies to sell their stock or their shares in the foreign stock market? How can they sell them? How can they, for example, get loans from international credit grantors such as World Bank or whatever, or foreign banks, whatever? How can we persuade banks to give us or to grant us a credit? They have to understand our financial statement. How can they understand it? When we provide them financial reporting by different language, by different accounting language. So also, this is one of the reasons for harmonization, or push us to harmonize our accounting credit. In addition to this one, we can add also the international accountancy firm support harmonization party because it's good for their large client as the auditor accountant, also to save or to keep their effort when they audit. It's a good point to harmonize our accounting treatment. For that, okay, you have to understand this. We have different accounting treatment around the world because of the reasons that we have discussed many times in previous videos and previous chapters. For that, for these, okay, we have differences, we have variables influence accounting, but because of the globalization and because we need to provide useful information to decision maker, such as potential and existent decision maker, that includes investors and bankers, we have to provide them the useful information that help them to make useful decisions. For that, we have to minimize the differences between countries, to minimize the or to provide useful information, useful accounting information. Now, next point, is it easy to do that? Actually not. We have many obstacles to harmonization. These obstacles are the reasons of the differences itself. Now, we have differences of culture, we have differences because of the legal system, we have differences because of the source of finance, etc. All of these points obstacles to harmonization. So we have to minimize these differences between the accountant who prepared the financial state, minimize the culture differences. You have to understand what the British accountants say. You have to understand in accounting language, I mean, not in English. You have to understand what American accountants say also. You have to understand Indian accountant. You have to understand their accounting language. To understand them, we have to standardize, or we have to harmonize our accounting treatment. We have to overlap the differences between accounting tongue around the world. One of the differences or obstacles to harmonization is the size of the present differences between the accounting practices, as I discussed a minute ago. Also, we have, for example, differences between investors for accounting, creditors, tax, conservatism. All of these factors, obstacles that cannot be overcome without major changes in attitude and laws. For that, in the coming part or sections, we will discuss how we overlap or overcome to minimize the changes in attitude and laws. Next point that we have to discuss, if purpose of financial reporting vary by country, it seems this is so important. Purpose of financial reporting vary by country, it seems reasonable that the reporting should vary because of the differences. But also, harmonization is most useful when it concerns similar users. We right now, because of the globalization, we have different users around the world. Here in Palestine Exchange, we have foreign investors. They need information to make decisions, to invest in our companies or to give our companies loans. So we are talking right now about similar users who receive information from companies in different countries. So it's so important to minimize the differences between accounting treatment between the different countries around the world. Last point that we are going to discuss only, I'll just only notify this. We have, right now, we have differences between the countries, and we aim to minimize these differences so we can measure the harmonization. To measure harmonization, we have statistical method for the measurement of de facto harmony, and for the measurement of harmonization, you can move to see the detail of these methods in page 93 and 94. Until now, I think it's enough to clarify the ideas of objective or of first section. Harmonization, reasons, obstacles, and measurement of harmonization. Let's go to the next.